I've been a professional athlete for my entire life. I was a tomboy as a kid. So I got involved with sports really super young, with cross country running, and I've been a rock climber, a kayaker, adventure racer, and most recently ultra endurance mountain bike racer. So it really is my lifestyle and turned into a profession.
What do people say when they learn about what you do and you tell them the stories and the anecdotes? I mean, how do people react to that?
Usually people think I'm crazy. You know, why do you want to ride 1,200 miles? My nickname is the Queen of Pain. People, they don't really understand wanting to go on such long journeys, for days, weeks, months, on a bicycle or on foot.
Now, of course, you lost your father in the Vietnam War. How do you think that has affected you as a person growing up?
It's not until recently that I feel that I've been able to recognize that that did affect me. You know, I was really young when my father was shot down. I was just three, so I don't have my own personal memories of him. And all through my career, I've gotten the question, what are you searching for? Why are you going so long? You know, what is it that drives you? And I've never really been able to answer that question other than I want to explore, I want to see places. But now, after my most recent journey down the Ho Chi Minh Trail, I realize you know, I've been searching for him and searching for a missing piece of myself this whole time, my whole career.
So tell me how the idea came about to go to Vietnam, to go on this epic adventure to try and find what happened to your dad.
The idea to ride the Ho Chi Minh Trail and look for where my dad was shot down, it's been marinating for a long time. I first went to Vietnam in 2003. And that was the first time physically being in the place where he spent time and visiting Da Nang Air Force Base, where he was stationed, and going to battlefields and really, really immersing myself physically. That was the first time I started to have curiosity about him and what his life was like and what his experience was like.
Yeah, what were you hoping for on this journey? What did you expect was going to happen?
What I expected was to have a great adventure and to experience the culture and the people and ride my bike for a long time and suffer and, you know, experience the jungle and have a grand adventure. I knew it would be emotional going to visit my dad's crash site, but I didn't have expectation of how it would feel or what would happen. And the trip unfolded into such a bigger gift than I ever could have imagined. I came back a completely different person with, you know, achieving my goal to go to the crash site, to ride the whole entire length of the Ho Chi Minh Trail. But I actually came home with another purpose and a purpose for my riding and a way to use my bike as a vehicle for change.
Can you describe your emotions when you got to the crash site, what that experience was like for you?
I think I was at peace. You know, my career is always go as fast as I can, you know, always kind of with blinders on, looking forward to a finish line, to a distance ahead of me. And when we got to the crash site, it was like time had stopped for me and I could finally slow down. I could finally rest and I could finally just be in that moment. And that's a rare, I don't experience that. I've never experienced that feeling in my entire life. And so it was just a stillness and a quietness that I'd really found me. I'd found part of myself.